this video is about CMAT preparation strategy. With around 6 weeks to go for CMAT, it becomes extremely important for us to understand what to concentrate on or what to study. Let us first understand what CMAT is. Common Management Admission Test, or CMAT as it is better known as, is an aptitude test conducted by AICTE for admission to around 400 B schools. The test is divided into four sections, namely quantitative techniques and data interpretation, logical reasoning, language comprehension, and general awareness. Let us understand each of these sections separately. Section 1, quantitative techniques and data interpretation. Now, CMAT has been following a pattern wherein one of the three major sections, that is quantitative techniques or data interpretation, logical reasoning, or language comprehension, turns out to be on a slightly tougher side. In 2015 and 2016, the section that was tough or slightly on the difficult side was quantitative techniques and data interpretation. The questions in this section range from topics like numbers and its applications, percentage and its application, ratio and its application, time and work, time speed distance, permutation combination, and probability. So you can see a fair number of questions are going to be based on arithmetic. Apart from these, there will be two or three questions on geometry and two or three questions on data interpretation. The questions on data interpretation would be either based on tables, bar graph, pie chart, and these are going to be very, very easy. As far as preparing for this section is concerned, be very, very clear with your fundamentals. Practice those tough concepts. Solve those tougher questions again and again. Second, work on your speed. Third, be very, very thorough with mental calculations. CMAT does not provide an online calculator. So you should be thorough with your tables, squares, and cubes. Section 2, logical reasoning. 13 or 15 out of 25 questions in this section are going to be sets which are based on arrangement and puzzles. But the catch here is each of these sets is going to have a single question. So this is what makes this section lengthy. Apart from 13 sets on arrangement and puzzles, there will be questions on dot relations, direction sense, coding decoding, series, and syllogisms, cause and effect, statement assumption, statement conclusion. As far as preparation for this section is concerned, you need to practice a minimum of 10 sets of arrangement and puzzles on a daily basis. Concentrate on what is asked in the questions and not on solving the entire set. Use options and practice 6 to 8 questions daily of topics based on verbal reasoning, like statement assumption, statement conclusion, statement course of action, statement argument, and syllogism. Section 3, language comprehension. This section has 15 questions which are based on reading comprehensions. These questions are spread across 4 reading comprehensions, one of which is slightly lengthier, probably would have a length of around 500 to 700 words. The remaining 3 passages would have a length of around 300 to 400 words. Now, most of the questions which are based on reading comprehensions are direct questions. Around 3 or 4 questions would be inferential questions. Of the remaining 10 questions that are non-RC based, there is a good weightage of vocabulary based questions like synonyms, antonyms, fill in the blanks, idioms and phrases, and analogies. There are around 2 or 3 questions which are based on grammar, like sentence correction or error detection. Apart from this, there are usually one or two questions based on parajumbles, critical reasoning and fact inference judgment. Now, in order to prepare for this section, it is extremely important that you solve 6 passages on a daily basis. Apart from 6 passages, learn 50 words, brush up your vocabulary, brush up your grammar concepts and practice 5 to 6 questions of parajumbles, critical reasoning and fact inference judgment each. Section 4, general awareness. Most of the questions in this section, by most of the questions I mean around 22 questions, are going to be based on static GK. There will be questions from a range of topics like history, geography, general science, economics, business, sports. The remaining 2 or 3 questions are going to be based on current affairs. There have been instances wherein they have asked a question like, identify the person or the logo in the given photograph. So now, how to prepare for a general awareness section of CMAT? First, brush up your static GK. By static GK, what I mean is, you should be aware of important historical events. There could be questions like, what triggered World War I? You should be aware about important geographical locations. There could be questions like, who completed the construction of Qutub Minar? You should be aware about basics of general sciences. There could be a question like, the adult human body has how many bones? And be abreast with all the current affairs that are happening around the world. Lastly, let us talk about the difficulty level of CMAT. You'll get a good idea by these numbers. In CMAT 2017, a score of 207 marks, that is, fetched 90 percentile. Whereas the same score in CMAT 2016 fetched 98 percentile. And in CMAT 2015 fetched 99 percentile. So this is a clear indication that CMAT has been altering the difficulty level of the test. So how do we prepare for such variations in difficulty level of CMAT? The solution is planned and systematic approach towards taking mock CMATs. See, there are 6 weeks to go for CMAT. For at least next 2 weeks, take 1 mock CMAT on a weekly basis. Analyze those mocks. Identify your strengths and weaknesses. Work on your weaker areas. Then, from the 3rd week onwards, start taking 3 mock CMATs. This will help you build your speed and momentum towards the actual CMAT. That will be all from our side. Keep practicing, keep appearing for mocks, convert your weaker areas into your stronger ones. All the best for your CMAT. Thank you.